regreso aquí en Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Mota y estamos en el verano y vamos a salir de vacaciones, vamos a tomar el auto, vamos a ir por la carretera, pero hay que preparar el auto, hay que estar listos para que no seamos uno de los 8 millones de conductores que todos los años llaman a la AAA. Y vamos a hablar con Mike Hawkins. Vamos a Now we're going to switch back to English. We're going to talk with Mike Hawkins, Manager of Technical Services at AAA, about how we should prepare our car or ourselves to, for summer drive. How are you, Mike?
Javier, thanks for having me on.
Thank you very much for the time. And as I was saying in the introduction, a lot of people take their vacation in the summer, obviously, and they take the car, but and they prepare, they make reservations for hotels, plane tickets, and all those things. But most times they don't take care of the car before they go on, right?
Well, you know, a lot of people do, but a lot of people don't. And in fact, AAA is going to end up servicing or helping around 8 million motorists over the summertime who didn't prepare their car properly for summer travel.
Yeah, that's amazing. 8 million people. And that's the people who have memberships with you guys, because that's probably a lot more than done. So
yeah, you're right.
You want to be within, if you're going to have an emergency, you want to be within that 8 million number, right?
Absolutely, although we hope that you don't have to call us. You know, we'd rather that you have an uneventful and fun vacation, but we'll be there if you need it.
Yeah, obviously, yeah. So there's a lot of things, and some of them are pretty obvious, but I think it's a good thing to remind people what they should do when they're going to prepare their car for a summer trip. And obviously, it depends on if it's going to be a short trip or a longer trip. So can you tell us about what are your main tips for people to do that?
Well, I think one of the big things that people overlook in the summertime is their battery. People tend to think of batteries causing problems in the winter when the weather's cold in a lot of the parts of the country. But the truth is that heat is the biggest single enemy of a battery. It breaks them down internally. It causes more corrosion. And in hot climates, batteries typically don't last a whole lot longer than only 3 years. So,
wow.
So if you live in that kind of a climate and your battery is 3 years old, it might be a good idea to have it checked out by a AAA-approved shop before you head out on a longer trip.
So you said if your car is 3 years old or older and you haven't checked your battery ever, you should take a look at that. And this battery technology has changed a lot, right? Because I remember in the old days, the batteries used to have a little, like six caps, and you would put like some liquid in it, and that's no longer the case, right?
Yeah, there are a few of those type batteries still around, but almost all the modern batteries are maintenance-free in that you can't open them up and add water to them. However, you do still need to make sure that the terminals are clean of corrosion, because that affects the electrical connection and can lead to problems.
Yeah, what would be one of the proper way of, if you're doing it yourself, to do that?
Well, what you need to do is, you know, disconnect the negative battery terminal first and then take them all the way, you know, disconnect both terminals, clean them thoroughly with a solution of baking soda and water, and flush that off real good with fresh water. And then there are simple tools that have wire brushes, so you can clean both the terminal and the inside of the cable connector, and then bolt it all back together tight, you know, putting on the positive terminal first and then the negative one.
Okay. And the next thing, obviously, is the summer, so we want to have cool air in the car, so the air conditioning is an essential part for the summer trip to be ready.
Yeah, I remember when I was a boy, we used to travel across the country in our 56 Chevy without air conditioning. And we'd always leave on trips at 2 in the morning because we lived in Nevada at the time.
Wow.
Tried to escape the heat. But most cars today do have air conditioning. And the good news about air conditioning is it really doesn't require any routine maintenance. You know, as long as it's blowing cold, you're in good shape. But if it's not as cold as it used to be, you know, then you might want to have it checked out before you leave, because any reduction in cooling indicates there could possibly be a leak or some other problem with the system.
A leak of the Freon, it's called, right?
Yeah, Freon, or today they use R134A, which is a more environmentally friendly refrigerant.
Yeah, and that can be also be done by yourself, or it's more recommended to go to a shop?
Well, I know that you can buy cans of refrigerant at your local auto parts store and add those, and some people do that. But the reality is, if you're already losing refrigerant, the problem's only going to get worse. So if you really want a long-term fix, it's better to take it to a shop that can find the location of the leak and repair that.
Yeah, that the source of the problem, instead of just like putting a little patch on it. So and then there are the fluids that are in the car, like the wipers, and that's really simple. But like again, some people just don't pay attention to that.
Yeah, I mean, the wipers and washers are critical to having good vision, particularly at night. You know, And there are easy things that you can do yourself. You know, you can buy replacement blades at your auto parts store. You know, and we suggest that you use a good washer fluid that's designed to help remove bugs during the summertime. And, of course, make sure that the little jets that spray on the windshield are pointing in the right direction.
Yeah, that's pretty, pretty funny because, I mean, in the summertime, the convertibles are not, especially here in South Florida, where it's so hot, and maybe as it was the case in Nevada where you were, sometimes you're behind the car and they're like, they're trying to clean their windshield and they're like spraying you.
Yeah.
Like one car behind you. So.
Yeah, I've had that experience too. That is funny. Yeah. All you have to do to fix that is just take a little pin and put it in the hole and just move it. It's like a little ball in a socket. And you just move the pin around a little bit to point it in the right direction.
Yeah, there's an amazing system now at Mercedes-Benz that has those sprayers within the blade. So
yes.
The water comes out immediately to the windshield. That's like pretty amazing. Little things that company thinks about, and it's just amazing when it comes out. It's like one of those, like, why did I think about that, right?
Yeah, the systems and the blades are really nice because they don't obstruct your vision when you're using them, because there's never any spray just sitting on the windshield. It's sprayed and gets wiped away immediately.
Yeah, but that's a more expensive replacement, changing your car for a Mercedes.
yes, it is very much more.
Anyway, so the next thing, obviously, an emergency kit for the roadside, and that can be very useful if you're like stranded on the road.
Yeah, you know, and the first thing we always put on our list is a mobile phone, and most people have mobile phones today. But it's kind of surprising how many people don't have a phone charger for their
car. Yeah.
I was talking to someone the other day. In fact, I think it was my daughter, as I recall, who said, "I can't talk to you. My phone's about to die."
Yeah, exactly. Why did you bring that charger? That's very, very important.
Yeah, a mobile phone's no good without a charge. So,
exactly.
So.
After a while. Another thing, I mean, one of the things that probably should have been on the top of the list, the tires, because not only the condition of the tire, the inflation of the tire, I read recently that if a tire is being, like, for example, a car that has been in the not been driven for a long time and the tire is old, the tire itself might be, the thread might be good, but the tire itself might be already in not its best condition.
Yeah, the tire manufacturers say that the average life of a tire is somewhere between 6 and 10 years, depending on, you know, whether it's out in the sun a lot or whether it's the car is parked indoors. But the rubber itself deteriorates from the sunlight and the ozone and the atmosphere. And you can usually see that when you visually inspect a tire. If the sidewall is all cracked, and it's called checking, it gets like a little pattern of cracks all over the sidewall. If you see that, that's a tire that's really pretty close to the end of its life. Even if there's tread left, the rubber is deteriorated to the point where you might want to think about some new tires.
Yeah, and once again, I mean, the roads are much warmer, much hotter with the sun in the summer. So if you have a tire that is already coming apart in pieces, I mean, that's going to affect that process to make it much faster, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And the other thing that's important is inflation, because we don't think about tire cooling, but like you say, in the summertime, the roads are hot. If your tire is underinflated, that creates a lot of friction internally in the tire, and it can cause the tire to overheat. And that's where really most of the blowouts you see, that's how they happen, is the tire is overheated from being driven in hot conditions and it being underinflated.
And the tires that you're driving on are important, but your spare tire might be even more important if you have a blow, right?
Yeah, it doesn't do much good to call AAA for us to come out and put on the spare if the spare is flat too.
So
we'll tow you, but
yeah, a good list of things we're posting in our Facebook page, facebook.com/auto060. But also, Mike, can you please share where the audience can look for more information from AAA?
Well, you can visit your local AAA club site, which you can find at AAA.com. And there's complete information about car care there, including the listings of our approved auto repair facilities, which can help you do the work that you're not comfortable doing yourself.
Yeah. And are you planning a trip yourself?
I actually have some business trips coming up, but once those are over, I hope to take my wife down to the Keys for our 25th wedding anniversary.
Oh, congratulations in advance. Yeah, the Keys is a very nice trip. That 7-mile bridge, once you get out of South Florida, is really, really nice. So I hope you do and you enjoy it.
Yeah, well, we went there before our wedding 25 years ago. So
you haven't been back?
Have not been back.
Well, you're going to find it very interesting. It has changed a lot.
I'll bet.
The road hasn't changed a lot, though. I mean, it's new, but it's still a two-lane bridge, especially on that stretch, which is beautiful anyway.
Yeah,
so,
it is beautiful.
Thank you very much, Mike. Mike Hawkins, manager of technical services at AAA. Thank you very much for your time and especially for your knowledge and sharing it with us here at our show.
Thank you, Javier.
Thank you. Mike Hawkins, gerente de servicios técnicos de la AAA, esa compañía que está ahí, que a veces no le ponemos mucha atención, pero que, como nos está diciendo, 8 millones de personas van a llamar a la AAA este verano por alguna emergencia en la carretera, así que ojalá que los consejos que nos ha dado Mike Hawkins sean de utilidad y que los pongan en práctica antes de salir en ese viaje de verano con el auto totalmente preparado para poder no solamente disfrutar el viaje, evitar accidentes, sobre todo evitar una emergencia en la carretera, que es lo más desagradable, porque ahí se arruina todo el plan del verano, de ese día. A veces los costos se multiplican cuando es una emergencia y no se tiene la protección de un servicio como la AAA. El costo de reparar un auto en la carretera es mucho más alto cuando se puede evitar todo eso con una simple revisión de algunas partes que son esenciales en el auto y que a veces damos por descontado y no le ponemos ninguna atención. Así que ahí están todos los consejos de Mike Hawkins, gerente de servicios técnicos de la AAA. Y antes de que nos vayamos al siguiente segmento, gracias a Cafa, que está de regreso, DJ Cafa aquí en los controles, ayudándonos en la producción del show. Ya regresamos aquí en Auto 060 con un par de entrevistas de eventos muy interesantes aquí en Miami. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota.